Hello everyone. Today we'll have to discuss about scalar triple product. What is it? Let us discuss scalar triple product. We'll use the term as like that A, B, and C. This is known as scalar triple product. This can be written in the form of vector A dot vector B cross C or vector B dot vector C cross A or dot vector C dot A cross B. So the meaning of this term is even 1, 2, 3, any result we can put. That means it should be followed a proper way, systematic way, ABC, ABC, BCA and CAB. As you know that in a cross product, you know in place of B cross C, if we want to write here C cross B, then the minus sign is coming out. So simply we can write here A dot C cross B also, but the minus sign will be coming out. So let us discuss about this concept. What is it? Scalar triple product. We are talking about a parallel pipe. Actually, the use of this scalar triple product to find the volume of a parallel pipe, a volume of a cuboid, like this. This is a cuboid. It's a cuboid. Okay. In this cuboid, we can consider, suppose this is, it is vector A, here is a vector B, and this indication has a vector C. These are actually, suppose it is x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, or because the direction is this. Okay. So vector A, it's denoted by A, B and it is C. It is denoted by OA, vector A, OB, it is vector B and OC, it is vector C. So this is the base part. And we are aware of that you know how to find the area of a parallelogram by the cross product. Simply we can multiply, that means the cross product of two adjacent sides in a magnitude is called the area. So that means the area of base of cuboid, area of base of cuboid, area of base. So area base, it is actually a rectangle, two adjacent sides, B, A and B. So directly I write here, vector A cross vector B. What is it? It is the area of base. It is the area of base. And for finding the volume of cuboid, area base multiplied by height. So volume of cuboid is equal to area of base multiplied by height. Is it okay? Area of base multiplied by height. Area of base A cross B multiplied by height. What is the height here? Height in the form of vector C. And you know that this A cross B, that means whatever the result vector is coming, resultant vector is coming, this vector will be perpendicular to A and B both. That means vector direction is this, vector is in this direction. Okay. So the direction of this vector is parallel to vector C. Am I right? Because this is a vector C and A cross B is coming in this direction. And so that means the vector C and vector A cross B both are parallel. And when two vectors are parallel, then their dot product is their multiplication simply. Because the dot product, that means the cos 0 and the cos 0 is 1. So simply the area of base multiplied by height. So what to write here? This is A cross B dot C. Is it okay? A cross B dot C. So A cross B dot C, what does it mean? Its magnitude. So that means the volume of cuboid is equal to A cross B dot C. And simply we can, because in the dot A dot B or B dot C, anything we can write here. So this can be written as a C dot A cross B also. There is no change in it. Okay, so simply we can write here C dot A cross B is called, this is called scalar triple product. This is a magnitude term. When you remove the magnitude term, that it is coming C dot A cross B. Okay, so this is the value of that term. So we can understand the concept of the scalar triple product is these three terms, A dot B cross C, B dot C cross A, C dot A cross B. Anything can be written. One more thing in that, let us discuss about that. A dot B cross C. If any one of A, B, C will be same, or we can write here A, B, C in place of A, B, C, write here vector A and vector B. In this case, what happens? The result will be A dot A cross B, A dot B cross A, and B dot A cross A. And what is the value of A cross A? A cross A, that means the cross product of two parallel vectors, their value is 0. So that means B dot A cross A is 0. So finally, its value is 0. Is it okay? So in all these three vectors, no vector should be same. If any two vectors are same, then the result is 0. Is it okay? So boys, this is the concept of that the area, volume of parallelogram is equal to area of base vector multiplied by its height vector. Okay, when we come put into the magnitude, that would be the volume of the cuboid. After that, we will verify this term by another way. I am going to verify it using three vectors, like vector A, I am taking A1i plus A2j plus A3k. Vector B is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k. Okay. And then we are going to verify this result, whether it is true or not true. Let us see. So this is, let vector A is equal to A1i plus A2j plus A3k. Vector B is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k. Vector C is equal to C3k. Okay. Let us take any one of them, vector A dot B, vector B cross C. So we are finding vector B cross C using the cross product I, J, K, B. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. It is B cross C. Okay. Taking this I, B2, C3 minus C2, B3 minus J. This is the second, because it is 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, minus 1 to the power 3, minus 1, always this J is negative. B1, C3 minus B3, C1 plus K. B1, C2 minus B2, C1. Okay, this is B cross C. This B cross C is multiplied by A dot B cross C. Now, A dot B cross C. What is the result? A, A1i plus A2j plus A3k dot B cross C. B cross C is this. So it is B2c3 minus C2b3 I minus B1c3 minus B3c1 j plus B1 C2 minus B2 C1 K. Okay. Got it? I dot product, you know that when in the dot product, I dot I 1, I dot J 0, I dot K 0. Okay, so only the same will be multiplied. So this is the scalar component of I A1. Here scalar component of I, it is B2 C3 minus C2 B3. So we'll multiply it. So it is coming A1 B2 सी थ्री माइनस ए वन सी टू बी थ्री. नाउ हियर विथ जे विथ जे, सो दिस ए टू माइनस बी वन सी थ्री साइन इज माइनस ए टू बी वन सी थ्री एंड दिस इज माइनस इनटू माइनस इट इज प्लस. सो ए टू बी थ्री सी वन ओके एंड के विथ के सो दैट इज कमिंग प्लस ए थ्री बी वन सी टू माइनस ए थ्री बी टू सी वन. ओके दीज आर द टर्म्स हियर ए वन बी टू सी थ्री. यू कैन सी दैट ए वन बी टू सी थ्री इज नो वेयर राइट. हियर देयर आर थ्री पॉजिटिव वन टू थ्री एंड देयर आर थ्री नेगेटिव. सो व्हेन आई टेक ए वन कॉमन ओके अननेसेसरी आई हैव मल्टीप्लाइड हियर. बाय द वे इफ यू विल राइट हियर द सेम टर्म लाइक दिस सपोज फ्रॉम हियर ए वन इज कॉमन सो बी टू सी थ्री माइनस बी थ्री सी टू माइनस ए टू कॉमन देन व्हाट हैपन्स माइनस ए टू कॉमन बी थ्री सी वन माइनस बी वन सी थ्री प्लस ए थ्री कॉमन बी वन सी टू माइनस बी टू सी वन. इज इट ओके राइट. इन दिस केस व्हाट हैपन्स यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज द रिजल्ट व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द डिटरमिनेंट वैल्यू ऑफ बी वन बी टू बी थ्री लाइक दिस. सी इट इज ए वन ए टू ए थ्री बी वन बी टू बी थ्री एंड सी वन सी टू सी थ्री. व्हेन आई सॉल्व दिस डिटरमिनेंट देन व्हाट हैपन्स सी ए वन लीविंग दिस कॉलम एंड रो बी टू सी थ्री माइनस बी थ्री सी वन माइनस बी थ्री सी टू सेकेंड माइनस ए टू बी वन सी थ्री माइनस बी थ्री सी वन एंड थर्ड वन इज प्लस ए थ्री दैट इज बी वन सी टू माइनस बी टू सी वन एंड यू कैन चेक इट दीज थ्री टर्म्स वन टू थ्री आर एग्जैक्टली सेम टू दीज थ्री टर्म्स. ओके एंड इफ द टर्म्स आर सेम व्हाट डज इट मीन. द मीनिंग इज दिस इज ए वन ए टू ए थ्री बी वन बी टू बी थ्री सी वन सी टू सी थ्री इन द डिटरमिनेंट लाइक ए बी सी इज इक्वल टू ए डॉट बी क्रॉस सी. सो ए डॉट बी क्रॉस सी कैन बी एक्सप्रेस लाइक दैट. इज इट ओके. सो वॉट डज इट मीन द अदर वे इज सपोज ए बी सी इज गिवन इन दैट एंड दीज आर द वैक्टर टर्म्स आर गिवन इन दैट फॉर्म. सो ओनली वी हैव टू राइट स्केलर कंपोनेंट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रो वाइज okay in the determinant and we'll calculate that we are getting the result of it. Or the second way of finding the result a dot b cross c. okay so this is the verification by this example. Now one more thing, one theorem is there, it's very important theorem and one thing very important because this is the exercise on your NCERT book which is printed extreme last after access after answer sheet. This is the exercise scalar triple product. Okay but it is important exercise. Scalar triple product is also one of the important part of your vector algebra. Let us discuss one theorem. Exercise is not very difficult, it's a simple exercise but theorem. One theorem is here in your NCERT book, that is coplanarity of the three vectors. One theorem is given. Three vectors A, B, C are coplanar if and only if A dot B cross C is equal to 0. Okay, so this is the theorem. Vectors A, B and C are coplanar if and only if vector a b c are coplanar if and only if a dot b cross c is equal to 0 or is equal to 0. Same thing. Okay, the meaning of if and only if, that means if this is there that we have to prove it, If it is given, then we have to group that ABC are coplanar. Coplanar, that means three vectors, they are coming on a same plane. Okay. So this is the theorem. It's an important theorem. We are going to prove that. Okay. So I am taking first if ABC are coplanar. Okay. Case 1. If A, B and C are coplanar. If A, B and C are coplanar, then what does it mean? This is a plane. On that plane, these are the vectors. Okay. These are the vectors. So I'll consider any one of, by the way, any two of the vectors, three of the vectors, three are given that. Okay. So we will consider, suppose B and C. Let B and C, suppose this is vector A, here's a vector B, another vector is C. We don't know about these. Okay, but they are coplanar. That means they are lying on the same plane. So there are some different conditions, and there are two cases possible. Suppose we are taking any two vectors which are either parallel or perpendicular. Because on a plane, we know that if two lines intersected each other, either they intersect each other or they are parallel. Okay, right? So here we are taking two conditions. If two vectors, they are non-parallel. Okay, they are non-parallel or they are parallel. So here we will take a condition. Suppose there are two vectors, vector B and vector C. Vector B and vector C, okay, they are not parallel. Are not parallel. Or first I am taking are parallel. If vector B and vector C are parallel, then what is the condition if when both the vectors are parallel, vector B and vector C are parallel? So their cross product is B cross B, and both are, that means sine 0, that is 0. So if vector B and vector C are parallel, that means direct way I write here, vector B cross vector C is equal to 0. Okay. Parallel, what does it mean? The angle is 0, theta is equal to 0, and sine 0 is equal to 0. So vector B cross vector C is equal to 0. It's okay. So vector B and vector C both are parallel. Then B cross C is equal to 0. That means A dot B cross C is equal to 0. First case. Okay. Second case, if vector B and vector C are perpendicular. If B and C are perpendicular. If they are perpendicular, what does it mean? Vector B cross vector C. What is the vector? The vector which we are getting, which is perpendicular to both B and C. So that means if B and C are perpendicular, so its vector is in this direction, and this vector is perpendicular to vector A. Okay. So here what happened? If B and C are perpendicular, that means vector B cross vector C is perpendicular to both vector B and vector C. Is that okay? And if it is perpendicular to both, that means its direction is like towards you, and this vector is perpendicular to B and C, and this is a plane. On that plane, there's a vector A lies. So this vector A and this vector B cross C, what is the relation between them? Their dot product is 0, because dot product vector A dot vector B is equal to AB cos theta cos 90 0. So vector A dot vector B cross C is equal to 0. So what to write here? Vector A dot B cross C is equal to 0. Is it okay? So these are the conditions in that. And by the way, in any case, you can take B cross C are perpendicular to each other. If they are not perpendicular, they are making an angle theta. But still the condition is, this vector is whatever the unit vector which is perpendicular to both the vectors, and that vector which is making a dot product with vector A or the remaining vector, always the result is 0. So A dot B cross C is equal to 0. So in all these cases, you can understand that if A, B, C are coplanar, then A dot B cross C is equal to 0. Is that okay? The condition is clear. you can take out of three, you are selecting any two vectors. Okay, whether you can take C vector remains as it is, A and B you can select. First condition, if A and B are parallel, then A cross B is equal to 0, then A dot B cross C is equal to 0. But if A and B are not parallel, second case, it is not parallel, that means they are having any angle between them, even it is a 90 degree or theta will be any angle. So what happens, their cross product will be the vector which is perpendicular to both A and B. And this vector is always perpendicular to the remaining vector. And the dot product between this vector and the vector is always 0. So in all cases, A dot B cross C is equal to 0. So one condition is clear, with A, B and C are coplanar, then A dot B cross C is equal to 0. Is it okay? First condition. If and only if, second case I want to take, suppose if A dot B cross C is equal to 0 and we want to prove that A, B, C are coplanar. Okay, A, B, C are coplanar. Now, second case. A dot B cross C is equal to 0. There are three cases. Either vector A is equal to 0, B cross C is equal to 0, or three cases, if A is equal to 0, or B cross C is equal to 0, or both 0. Okay. If A dot B cross C is equal to 0, what does it mean? Vector A is equal to 0, or vector B cross C is equal to 0, or vector A dot B cross C is equal to 0. We are having three conditions. Okay. Suppose I want to take first condition. If vector A is equal to 0. If A is equal to 0, what does it mean? Vector B cross vector C is equal to 0. And vector B cross vector C is equal to 0, what does it mean? The meaning is B and C are parallel. Is it okay? Because their cross product is 0, what does it mean? They are parallel to each other. And if they are parallel, what does it mean? They are on the same plane. So that means they are coplanar. Right, second, already A is given here. Second case, if B cross C is equal to 0, then also we have proved it. Okay, next one is, if both are not equal to 0, then what happens? A dot B cross C is equal to 0. Okay, so in this case, their dot product is equal to 0. Dot product is equal to 0, what does it mean? This is perpendicular to B cross C. Okay. Vector A, magnitude of vector A is perpendicular to vector B cross C as per the dot product definition. Vector A dot B cross C are perpendicular to each other. But B cross C, what is the value of it? The vector which is perpendicular to both B and C. So if the vector which is perpendicular to both B and C, that means its direction is towards direction A. So still what happens? All these three vectors are coming in a plane. Is it okay? The direction of B cross C is perpendicular to B cross C. And this direction is parallel to vector A. So that means all these three vectors lying on the same plane. So what does it mean? If A, B, C are coplanar, then vector A, vector B, vector C is equal to 0. Is it okay? So this is the theorem. It's an important theorem. You'll keep in your mind. You should know that, how to explain it. And for explanation, remember the definition is dot product and cross product, which is always used. Now we can start exercise 10.5. First question, ABC. If ABC given, we are going to find ABC. क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, फाइंड स्केलर ट्रिपल प्रोडक्ट एबीसी, वेक्टर्स आर गिवन, एबीसी आर गिवन, ए इज इक्वल टू आई माइनस टू जे प्लस थ्री के, बी इज इक्वल टू टू आई माइनस थ्री जे प्लस के, एंड सी इज इक्वल टू थ्री आई प्लस जे माइनस टू के. ओके, फाइंडिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट. ओके, सो सिंपली एबीसी कैन बी रिटर्न डायरेक्ट इन द फॉर्म ए डिटरमिनेंट फॉर्म, स्केलर कंपोनेंट्स वन माइनस टू थ्री, सेकेंड टू माइनस थ्री वन, एंड थर्ड थ्री वन माइनस टू, टेकिंग वन लीविंग दिस कॉलम एंड रो, सिक्स माइनस वन प्लस टू बिकॉज इट वॉज माइनस, माइनस माइनस प्लस टू, लीविंग दिस कॉलम एंड रो माइनस फोर माइनस थ्री, एंड थर्ड वन इज थ्री लीविंग दिस कॉलम एंड रो टू प्लस नाइन. ओके, सो वन सिक्स माइनस वन इट इज फाइव, प्लस टू माइनस सेवन, प्लस थ्री इट इज इलेवन. सो फाइव माइनस फोर्टीन प्लस थर्टी थ्री, थर्टी थ्री प्लस फाइव इट इज थर्टी एट, माइनस फोर्टीन, सो फोर एंड टू ट्वेंटी फोर. ओके, सो इट्स रिजल्ट, इट्स वैल्यू इज ट्वेंटी फोर. और सेम एज क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकेंड, शो दैट द वेक्टर ए बी सी आर कोप्लेनर. If the vector ABC are coplanar, what does it mean? Their determinant value will be 0. Suppose this value will coming 0, what does it mean? These three vectors are coplanar. So your second question based on that, you will put these three vectors here, solve it, and you are getting the 0, and result is 0, that means their vectors are coplanar. It's okay. So second question for you. Third one, find lambda if the vectors this, this and this are coplanar. Okay. This by the question number 3 you will understand the second question also. We are going to find the value of lambda for the vectors I minus j plus k, I minus j plus k, one vector. Second vector is 3i plus j plus 2k, 3i plus j plus 2k, and third one is I plus lambda j minus 3k, I plus lambda j minus 3k. R coplanar. It is given that R coplanar. Okay. Then find lambda. So if they are coplanar, what does it mean? 1 minus 1 and 1, 3, 1 and 2, and 1 lambda and minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay. It is already given that coplanar. We have already proved the theorem of coplanarity. So solve it. 1, leaving this column and row, minus 3 minus 2 lambda. Second term with minus sign, minus into minus, it is plus 1. This is always having opposite sign. Take leaving this column and row, minus 9 minus 2. Plus third one is 1, 3 lambda minus 1. Is equal to 0. So the result is minus 3 minus 2 lambda minus 9 minus 2, it is minus 11, plus 3 lambda minus 1 is equal to 0. We'll collect the like terms, 3 lambda minus 2 lambda, it is lambda, minus 3 minus 1 minus 4, and minus 11, it is minus 15, is equal to 0. Therefore lambda is equal to 15. So the value of lambda is equal to 15 when all these three vectors are coplanar. Okay. Next question number 4 is, if vector A, B and C given, then C1 is equal to 1, C2 is equal to 2, C3, which makes angle ABC coplanar. Okay. Two values are given and we will put the value of coplanarity again. ABC is equal to 0. vector A is given, B, C is given, then if C1 is equal to 1, C1 is equal to 1 and C2 is equal to 2, find C3, which makes ABC coplanar. So again, the condition is given, ABC coplanar, we will put the determinant value is equal to 0, two values given, and we are finding the unknown term, that is C3. Okay. Second part, C2 is equal to minus 1, C2 is equal to 1, C3 is equal to 1, then that no value of C1 can make ABC coplanar. So in this case, I think no value is coming. Fourth question, second part I am solving. No value is coming like this. Let us see. A is equal to I plus J plus K. Vector B is equal to only I, and vector C is equal to C1i plus C2j plus C3k. Okay. B part is there, but first you will see the first part. Just let me explain. In the first part, it is given that C1 and C2. Two values are given, C1 is equal to 1, C2 is equal to 2. So there's no problem. You can put here 1i plus 2j plus 3k. And the vectors, this is coplanar. So coplanar, what does it mean? In the determinant, write 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, C3 is equal to 0. And with the help of that, we will find the value of C3. Is it okay? Clear? Okay, I'm solving it. G. 1, 1, 1, I. Only I is here. So 1 other terms, J and scalar components are 0 here, J and K. Here it is, C1 is given that 1, C2 is equal to 2, and C3 is there. And they are saying that the value of C1, 1, and C2, 1, C2, 2, then these three vectors are coplanar. So that means that this means it's equal to, it is 0. So taking 1, leaving this column and row, 0 minus 0. So 0 is coming. Okay. Minus 1. C3 minus 0. Plus 1. Only 2. Is equal to 0. So that is 0. Minus C3 plus 2 is equal to 0. That means C3 is equal to 2. Okay. So the value of C3 is equal to 2 and 3 are coplanar. B part of it, B part is very interesting. In B part, it is given that C2 is equal to minus 1, C3 is equal to 1. Then show that no value of C1 can make these three vectors coplanar. Okay. C2 is equal to 1, minus 1 here. So again, I am writing here 1, 1, 1. It is 1, 0, and 0. And C2 is equal to minus 1. So C1 remains as it is. C2 minus 1. And C3 is given plus 1. Okay. And in the question, show that no value C1 can make ABC coplanar. So no value can make this as a coplanar. Okay. See, for coplanarity, is equal to 0 will be coming here. So now let us see which condition is coming with that. Okay. Suppose I'll put here 0. Then what happens? 1. Leaving this column and row, it is 0 minus 0. It is minus 1. Again, it is 1. It is plus 1. It is minus 1. Okay. So this is 0. It is minus 1. And it is minus 1. So what is this? Here it is coming minus 2. Okay. And C1 is not seen here. So if C1 is not seen here, so this minus 2, for eliminating this minus 2, we need plus 2. Only then this is coming 0. Okay. So I think this minus 2 will never be equal to 0. So that means no value of C1 we have. Okay. So the no value of C1, which makes vectors coplanar. Okay. Which makes no vector coplanar. Because this value is not here. If c1 is here, then we can put here, okay, c1, we can put plus 2, it becomes 0. But because c1 is eliminated from here, that means we don't have any option. We will not get the term is equal to 0. That means it is not coplanar for any value of c3. Okay. Question number 5. Show that 4 points with position vectors are given are coplanar. This is also the same question. Position vectors are given, so we'll find out AB, AC, and AD. Okay, and the coplanarity same thing. Scalar triple product will be proved as a zero. Question number 5. 4 vectors are given, 4i plus 8j plus 12k. 4i plus 8j plus 12k. Number 1. Second, 2i plus 4j plus 6k. Third point, 3i plus 5j plus 4k. And last fourth point, 5i 8j plus 5k. Okay. Show that 4 points, the position vectors are coplanar. Okay. 4, 8, 12, 2, 4, 6, 4, 8, 12, 2, 4, 6, 3, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, and 5, 8, 5. Okay, so we'll consider that the position vectors be, this is a point, point A, A has a B, that is C, and this point is suppose D. It's okay. So now we are going to find, because when we are going to find the coplanar, for coplanar, for coplanarity of A, B, C, and D, we can take AB, AC, AD is equal to 0. Okay. AB, AC, and AD vector is equal to 0. Because these are the points the position vectors are given. So when the position vector of the points are given, we have to find out the sides. So first of all, we are finding the AB. AB, how to find AB? Position vector of B minus position vector of A, like that. Position vector of B minus position vector of A. So direct I am going to subtract 2i minus 4i. It is minus 2i. 4j minus 8j, it's minus 4j. And 6 minus 12, it is minus 6k. Now position vector of AC, position vector of C minus position vector of A. C minus A. C minus A, 3 minus 4 minus I, 5 minus 8 minus 3, and 4 minus 12 minus 8. AD, position vector of D minus position vector of A. T minus A, 5 minus 4 I, 8 minus 8 is 0, and 5 minus 12 it is minus 7. Okay. So now we are finding the value in determinant form, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6. It is minus 1, minus 1, minus 3, minus 8. It is 1, 0, minus 7. Okay. Let us solve minus 2, leaving this column and row, 7, 3, 21. It minus minus plus 4, leaving this column and row, 7. 7 plus 8, 15. Because this is minus minus, it is plus 7. And 1 minus into minus, it is plus. 7, 15. And it's a minus 6. 0 plus 3. So the result is minus 42 plus 60 minus 18. So 18 minus 42, it is minus 60 plus 60 is equal to 0. And what does it mean? Points, four points are coplanar. Okay. Therefore, final answer you can write here. And so these are the, show that the four points with Poisson vectors are coplanar. Okay. So these are the, they are Poisson vectors. A, B, C, D and A, B, A, C, A, D are coplanar. Right. Now I want to take one more question of this exercise. Find x such that the four points are coplanar. The same thing is there. We'll find A, B, A, C, A, D and find out. The exact question number 6 is the same as question number 5. Seventh question, show that the vectors A, B, C coplanar if A plus B, B plus C, C plus A are coplanar. Interesting and important question. Show that vectors A, B, C coplanar if A plus B, B plus C and C plus A are coplanar. Given coplanar. So may I write vector A plus B, B plus C, C plus A is equal to 0 given. What is it? It is given. So a coplanar, that means scalar triple product is equal to 0. Now we are going to show that how A, B, C are coplanar. Okay. Right. As for the definition, may I write vector A plus vector B dot vector B plus C cross vector C plus A. Okay. A dot B cross C. A dot B cross C. Now, B cross C. So, may I use the term as this is A dot B cross C. B cross C, the cross product is here. So vector A plus vector B dot B cross C. B cross vector B cross C plus vector B cross A plus vector C cross C and plus vector C cross A. Is that okay? So over two vector B cross C plus B cross A plus C cross C plus C cross A. After that, vector A dot B cross C plus vector A dot B cross A, this is, plus vector A dot C cross C plus vector A dot C cross A. Is it okay? This A is multiplied to 4. Plus vector B dot B cross C plus vector B dot B cross A plus vector B dot C cross C and plus vector B dot C cross A. Is it okay? One thing very clearly I told you, if any two of the vectors are same, then their scalar triple product is, of course, 0. So here let us find out. A, B, C are different. A, B, A, they are same. 0. Okay. How can we say that they are same? Because B cross A, that means we are getting the perpendicular vector, which is perpendicular to B and A. So that means the vector which is perpendicular to A. So this vector is perpendicular. and the dot product of two perpendicular is 0. So that is 0. C cross 2 is 0. A and A is 0. B and B 0. B and B 0. C and C 0. Okay. So out of 3, if any two are same, that means their scalar triple product is 0. Already we have discussed. Once again, let me explain you. For example, suppose this I have explained, B cross A. That means the resultant which we are getting, that is a unit vector or vector which is perpendicular to B and A both. So this vector which is perpendicular to A. So this vector is perpendicular to A. Dot product of A and A. Dot product of A and A. 0. Is it okay? A and A. Dot product cos 90 and cos 90, that is 0. After that, here C cross C. If C cross C both are coming same, what does it mean? Both the vectors are same. When we are using the cross product, then angle between them is equal to 0, so sine 0, therefore C cross C is equal to 0. Same as here, they are 0, 0, 0, 0. So only two are left. One is A dot B cross C. Plus B dot C cross A. Plus B dot C cross A. Okay. B dot C cross A. What does it mean? And the question is asking that, okay, so that vector ABC are coplanar. So here it is coming. Because these terms are equal to, given that 0. Find it. So everything is equal to 0. So here A dot B cross C. ABC. Plus B dot C cross A. It is ABC. Is equal to 0. So that means it is 2. ABC. Is equal to 0. So 2 will be shifted here. ABC is equal to 0. What does it mean? ABC are coplanar. Okay. So this is the proof of question number 7. Okay. I hope you enjoyed with this exercise. I hope you have understood each and every question of the exercise. Thank you. Thank you very much.